Welcome to the first of several videos on solving two-step equations. This video will solve the most basic type of two-step linear equations. Remember, the goal of solving any linear equation is to isolate the variable. When we have a basic two-step equation, the first step is going to be to add or subtract in order to isolate the variable term, and then step two is going to be to multiply or divide to solve for the variable. And step three, we should check all possible solutions. Remember, to maintain equality, we must perform the same operation on both sides of the equation. Let's take a look at our examples. So here we have 2x plus 3 equals 9. Remember, 2x means 2 times x. So we have multiplication here and we have addition here that we have to undo. So we want to undo the addition first, so we'll subtract 3 on both sides. So we'll have 2x on the left, plus 3 minus 3, that's going to be 0, that's why we did that. On the right we have 9 minus 3, that'll be 6. And now we have 2x, so to isolate the variable we have to undo this multiplication, so we'll have to divide by positive 2. And again, we have to divide both sides by positive 2. So 2 over 2 would give us 1 times x, or just x. And then 6 divided by 2, x is equal to 3. Let's check it. 2 times x, or 2 times 3, that would be 6, plus 3 does equal 9. Number 2, we have 5x minus 8 equals 22. Again, 5x means 5 times x minus 8 equals 22. So we need to undo the addition or subtraction first. Well, the opposite of minus 8 would be plus 8. And we can do this as long as we do the same on the right side. So on the left we have 5x, and then minus 8 plus 8, that's 0, that's why we did that. Remember, our goal is to get this variable x by itself. And then on the right side we have 22 plus 8, that would be 30. And now to isolate the x we have to get rid of this 5, it's attached by multiplication. So we'll divide both sides by 5. 5 over 5 is equal to 1, so we have 1x, or x. And on the right side, 30 divided by 5 would be 6. X is equal to 6. Let's look at a few more. Now, number 3 sometimes causes some confusion. We have 9 minus 2x equals 23. This is a positive 9, and then we have minus 2 times x. So we need to undo this positive 9 by adding or subtracting. Well, to undo a positive 9, we're going to have to subtract 9 on both sides. We can't add 2 here because this 2 is attached by multiplication. So 9 minus 9, that's going to be 0. So we're left with minus 2x, or you could think of this as plus negative 2x. So we'll bring down a negative 2x. Equals, here we have 23 minus 9, that's going to be 14. Now again, we have to be careful here. This is negative 2 times x, and the opposite of multiplication is division. So next we need to divide both sides by negative 2. Negative 2 over negative 2 is positive 1 times x, which gives us x. Here we have 14 divided by negative 2. Be careful with the sign here, that's going to be negative 7. Number 4, we have negative 11 equals 4x minus 43. The variable is on the right side this time, so we're trying to isolate this x right here. The 4 is attached by multiplication. This is attached by subtraction. So to undo the subtraction first, we'll have to add 43 on both sides. Again, watching our signs here, negative 11 plus 43, that's going to give us positive 32, equals, we have 4x, and then minus 43 plus 43, that's going to be 0. And the last step, we have 4 times x. We're trying to isolate x, so we'll divide both sides by 4. Simplify, we have 32 divided by 4, that's 8, equals 1x, or just x. 8 equals x is the same as x equals 8. I think we have one more. Here we have negative 15 equals 5 minus 5x. Again, we're trying to isolate the variable that's on the right side. So we get done, we should have something that looks like this. So we have to think to ourselves, which of these can we get rid of or undo by adding or subtracting? Well, this 5 here is attached by multiplication. This is a positive 5, so we could get rid of this by subtracting 5 on both sides. Let's be careful here. Negative 15 minus 5. That's going to be negative 20 equals, well, 5 minus 5, that's 0. That's why we did that. So now we're left with minus 5x, or you could think of it as a plus a negative 5x. So we'll bring down negative 5x. We're trying to isolate the x. We have negative 5x. That means negative 5 times x. So the opposite of multiplication is division. We're going to divide by negative 5. So here we'll have negative 20 divided by negative 5. That's positive 4. And on the right side, negative 5 divided by negative 5 is positive 1. 1 times x is x, so we're done. 4 is equal to x, or x is equal to 4. And that'll do it for this first video. I hope you found these examples helpful.